Hey there, I'm Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. So in this video, we are going to see how can we pass the image path into the UI path forms dynamically. So I have made a previous video on this as well. How can we display PDF and images in UI path forms by giving the path directly in the component? But what if the path is changing dynamically and it depends every time it is being executed? So in this video, we are going to see only how can we pass the UI, the image path directly into the UI path forms and dynamically. So without any delay, let's get started. Okay, so what I have done is I have already built the workflow, right? And don't worry about the workflow. As you know, I have started giving the GitHub repo link in the description. You can just go ahead there and download the complete workflow. So now first, let me show you the official documentation. We can see right here, local image file is we can give directly in the content element, HTML content. But now if I want to pass it dynamically, I need to convert it into a base 64 encoded image, which you can see over here. So let's read the documentation. You can also use an HTML element form component configured to maintain an image converted into base 64. If, for example, the image you want to use converted to base 64 is stored in a variable called img, you have to enter the following code in the content section of the component. So we need to provide it in this way. But here, there's one more thing that we need to type. So we'll see that. So first of all, what I have done is I have created a variable called loco that has the path of my image. As you can see over here, radio.png. So this was the previous video in the UI path forms playlist. And I have one more variable, string base 64 image. So what we have to do is basically we have to convert this particular image to a base 64 string and then pass that particular value into the UI path form. So let's see how to convert it into base 64 form and display it in the UI path form. So the first thing that you need to do is drag an assign statement and type this particular syntax: convert.toBase64 string system.io.file. So this is because we want to read the data from a file. So system.io.file, read all bytes. This is what you need to keep in mind. System.io.file is we have used many times and it is very much common. But here you see, this is the main thing that you need to type: read all bytes, and in bracket, you need to give the variable or the path of your image. So here you see my path is stored in the variable called logo. So this is the simple syntax that you need to assign first to your variable, which is getting converted to a base 64 string, or which is storing the base 64 string basically. So you see convert.toBase64 string, system.io.file, read all bytes, and logo. So once this is done, the second syntax is our data is going to be image and the format is png of type base 64. So did you see the breakdown? Data is the keyword that we are specifying. Now what kind of data? That is my image slash it is going to be a png image, and here you see we are passing the base 64 string. So after comma I am typing the variable, which is the previous variable where we have stored the base 64 string. So this is the another syntax that you need to keep in mind: data image png base 64 string base 64 image. So this is the second simple syntax that you need to keep. Now later what you need to do is, first let's create the form and then we'll go ahead with this. So in form, what I've done is first I've used this HTML element and I have typed this particular text. Let it get displayed, displaying image dynamically, right? And below that I have dragged this content. So even if you've seen the documentation, it is written content over here. You have to enter the following code in the content section of the environment. So this is my content section where this was the content section right over here. Right. So we have given this particular text and now my image. So for that you need to have HTML element, right? And let me show you the code that we need to write. Now first make sure the HTML tag is p, right? No attributes, no values required, and you have to type this particular syntax. Now you see this is similar to this image source colons curly brackets, and in bracket we are passing our variable. So now my variable is logo image, right? But what I am doing is I am writing the word data. So it is taking the value that is stored in this particular variable. So you need to write data dot logo image. So if you see, if I remove the data keyword, we'll automatically see the error. You see, logo image is not defined. So that is the reason I need to type data. Okay, I think there's a typing mistake. Yes. So data dot logo dot img. So now where is this logo dot img coming from? Let me save this. Save this. Another styling you can give depending upon the HTML styling that you need to give. Here is that logo img. So in the form field collection, what you need to do is you need to have the variable that you want to pass into the UiPath form. So data dot logo img, and it is having my the last string based 64 image variable. So that's the value. So let me save it and run the file. So now you see the image is displayed over here. This is my thumbnail of the previous video in this same particular playlist. So you see this is center aligned, right? And the image is displayed over here. Now what if I change the path? Okay. So let me change the path to some other image. Okay, let's take this / inventory, copy, let me clear this. So I'm going to save this and execute. You see the image display. This is the screenshot of one of the UiPath apps videos that I have uploaded, inventory dashboard, how to build a dashboard using UiPath. So you see, as I changed the part, the image got changed and its size is same. If we see, this is 700 width that we have given. So this is how we can pass the image path dynamically into the UiPath forms with just two simple steps. And make sure if you need the workflow, it is there in the description, the GitHub repo link along with the different videos of UiPath forms as well. Thank you for watching the complete video. Please do subscribe to my YouTube channel, Parth Doshi, Learning by Doing. We are close to crossing 100,000 subscribers. Thank you.